Hello and welcome. Australian Charles Bud Tingwell was one of Australia's best loved actors. His career began in radio, but after service in the RAAF in World War II, he moved to Hollywood. A short stint in London television extended there to 16 years. As an actor, then as a director, he also worked on some of Australia's favourite TV series, including Homicide, The Sullivans, The Flying Doctors, and starring in films such as Break a Morant, The Castle, and Innocence. Let us look at his military service in World War II. He grew up in Sydney and in 1941, aged 18, volunteered for overseas war service with the Royal Australian Air Force. Under the British Commonwealth Air Training Plan, personnel from Commonwealth Air Forces form part of the Joint Training and Assignment System. Tingwell initially trained on tiger moths in Australia and left in 1942 with just 60 hours in his logbook, bound for Canada. The younger, better pilots were assigned to fighter training and the others trained as bomber pilots, navigators and air crew. Despite damaging a Harvard training aircraft in August, he later qualified as a pilot and was commissioned as a pilot officer that December. From Canada, he went to Bournemouth in the UK for assignment. He was hoping for a photo reconnaissance role as there were less casualties in that area. He was posted to the Mediterranean Theatre and underwent operational training in British Palestine, qualifying on Hawker Hurricanes and Supermarine Spitfires. He was posted to a photo reconnaissance unit, number 680 Squadron RAAF, and flew sorties in Mosquitoes and Spitfires. They flew up to 27,000 feet with cameras that had large lenses that took stereoscopic photographs. Then there was low-level flying at about 300 feet with an oblique camera fixed on the side of the aircraft. Eventually, he converted to the Mosquito, which had two engines and a navigator. Besides North Africa and Sicily, he flew over occupied Greece, Crete, Cyprus and Rhodes. Some targets were more dangerous than others. Athens was a tough one and Salonika was a really tough one. The flak was deadly. He said, "We concentrated on our straight run-ins and had to ignore flak. We didn't know until we developed photographs when we saw a big burst of anti-aircraft fire in the middle of a photograph. And you thought, oh, if that had been a few feet higher, we wouldn't have known what hit us." Tingwell flew 75 sorties in 12 months. He was also qualified to fly the Bristol Blenheim, Martin Baltimore, Bristol Beaufighter and the Airspeed Oxford. He was promoted to Flight Lieutenant in December 1944. In early 1945, Tingwell was transferred back to Australia. He was posted to No. 5 Operational Training Unit, RAAF, as a flight instructor, and then to 87 Squadron RAAF flying photo reconnaissance Mosquitoes over the Dutch East Indies. In 1946, Tingwell was given his first film role as a control tower officer in Smithy. The casting director said, "Have you come about a part?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Is that your own uniform?" I said, "Yes." "Can you read lines?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "Good. You're in, providing you bring your own RAAF uniform." In 2004, Tingwell published a memoir, Bud, A Life. Tingwell was appointed a member of the Order of Australia in 1999 for his contribution to the performing arts as an actor, director and producer. He died in Melbourne in 2009 and was given a state funeral. Thank you for watching.